Hi, this is Ron Latino. If you've ever used Panasonic cameras like G7 for example, you must know the dummy batteries can only be powered from an external AC supply. The reason is how the camera detects the dummy battery. If a standard lithium-ion pack is inserted, its voltage may range approximately from 7.4 volts to 8.4 volts, and the camera will be happy with it. However, if you power your G7 using a dummy adapter and apply voltage within this same range, the camera will refuse to work, throwing you off with an error message. For the device to accept the dummy, you must supply it with DC of at least 8.4 volts. I would say 8.5 to be sure. So, if you're up to powering your Panasonic with an external battery, say the popular Sony NP970, you're in trouble, because that will simply not work. In this video, I will show you a very simple mod you can apply to a dummy battery adapter to make your camera think it's being powered by an original lithium-ion cell. Here's the deal. If we look at the DMW PLC12 battery carefully, we may notice that it has 4 pins. Negative, positive, T, and D. The first 2 pins actually supply the power, while the T pin reports battery temperature in the form of resistance. The hotter the battery, the lower the resistance. Room temperature corresponds approximately to 10K. To check it, just heat the battery up by rubbing. You'll see the resistance between the ground and the T-pin go down. Now, if we jig the T-pin on the dummy, we can see the multimeter show infinity, which means the T-pin is simply not connected. See where I'm going with this? Yep. All we have to do to make it work is install a 10K resistor between the ground pin and the T-pin. So let's do it. As we can see, the PCB here is completely empty. Only positive and negative wires are attached. On this particular board, the resistor goes exactly here. But yours, mind you, may be different. So you have to use your multimeter in continuity check mode to find out which pads the resistor must be soldered to. While you're done, important, again, use the multimeter to check whether you now have 10K resistance between the ground and the T-pad. If you don't, recheck your wiring. Gonna secure the cable and apply some glue here. And we're done. As we can see, the camera now displays the battery icon, which it did not before. And now it can also be powered from an external battery tube. If you found this information actually useful, as a way of saying thank you, I would like to ask you to share it on photography forums like DP Review or Reddit's R Photography. Also, if you've managed to modify a battery using my method, be Panasonic or any other camera model, please share your experience in the comments section below. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Be good. This was Ron Latino.